Panama disease, tropical race 4, is arguably the most devastating of all known banana diseases. There is currently no effective treatment for infected plants, so early detection and containment is critical to limit its spread. Infected plants must be reported immediately, so it is important that all staff and contractors who regularly enter banana paddocks know how to detect and report suspect plants. If you're unsure about any symptoms that you have seen, talk to your farm manager. There are both internal and external symptoms associated with the disease. The external symptoms include leaf yellowing, wilting of leaves, and stem splitting. The first symptom that is likely to appear is yellowing of the lower or older leaves. This typically occurs from the leaf edges and continues further into the leaf towards the midrib. You may initially notice that the plant lacks a healthy green colour in the leaves, and that the edges or parts of the leaves will be pale or starting to yellow before dying. It is important to report any plants that have yellow leaves, even if they are showing symptoms that are similar to those you have seen in the past. As the lower leaves die, they wilt and collapse, forming what can be described as a skirt of dead and dying leaves around the plant. Sometimes the dead leaves may remain upright. The younger leaves may also start to yellow, although depending on the severity of the infection, may remain green and upright. Another symptom to keep an eye out for is splitting of the stem. Early splitting will usually occur at the base of the plant and only extend a couple of layers into the stem. However, in later stages of the disease, this splitting can become more obvious and extend much further up and into the stem. It's important to keep an eye out for infected plants, as these may appear within or be obscured by healthy-looking plants. As an exercise, see how many sick plants you can spot in this photo. The main internal symptom of the disease is discoloration or darkening within the stem. This darkening can range in colour from reddish to dark brown to black, and is particularly obvious in later stages of the disease. It is very important that you do not attempt to cut the stem of any suspect plants. Cutting an infected plant triggers the fungus to produce spores that can survive in the soil for decades. Cutting or removing plants also increases the risk of spreading the disease and also affects the integrity of the sampling process, required to confirm or rule out the presence of Panama Tropical Race 4. If you do find plants showing any of the external symptoms mentioned, report them as soon as possible to your farm supervisor. Talk with your farm supervisor or farm manager about how and when this should be done. The usual method is to mark the suspect plant with flagging tape or paint, and also mark the end of the row that the plant is in. It's also a good idea to make note of the block, as this will aid in relocating the suspect plant. If you have a camera or mobile phone, take photos to aid in identification. If possible, photograph the whole plant, a close-up of the yellowing or wilting leaves, any stem splitting that is evident, and any other symptoms that you see. Your farm manager or supervisor may also mark the location of the suspect plant onto a farm map to further assist in locating the plant. Remember to look out for any plants that have yellow leaves, wilting leaves, or stem splitting. Also, if you see a suspect plant, remember, do not cut the stem, as this can cause the disease to spread. In Queensland, Panama disease, tropical race 4, is a notifiable disease under the Plant Protection Act. This means that by law, you and your farm manager must report any suspect plants to Biosecurity Queensland within 24 hours of sighting them. For more information or to report suspect plants, contact Biosecurity Queensland on 13 2523. It is in everyone's interest to report potentially diseased plants as soon as they are detected. It's through a combination of early detection, identification, and on-farm biosecurity that we can limit the spread of this disease and ensure the future of the Australian banana industry.